In this video presentation, we highlight the technical aspects of a robotically assisted laparoscopic radical cystoprostatectomy with special emphasis on an appropriately performed lymph node dissection. The patient is placed in extreme Trendelenburg position. Configuration of the laparoscopic port sites is demonstrated. Once all port sites have been inserted under direct vision and the robot is docked, the operation commences with mobilization of the ascending colon and dissection of the left ureter. We attempt to leave adequate tissue on the ureter to avoid potential ischemic damage and stricture formation post the ureteroileal anastomosis. Once the ureter has been dissected into the deep pelvis just before its insertion into the bladder, the distal end is tied off with color-dyed ficral ties and divided. A section of the proximal cut ureter is sent for frozen section analysis to ensure the absence of carcinoma in situ or frank tumor. The ureter is then mobilized in a cephalad direction to prevent inadvertent injury during the lymph node dissection. The tie on the ureter also allows for ureteral dilatation to facilitate the ureteroenteric anastomosis. The lymphadenectomy commences at the level of the para-aortic lymph node tissue, using a combination of blunt and sharp dissection. Bipolar energy is utilized to prevent postoperative lymphatic leak. All peripheral vascular branches are controlled utilizing a combination of electrocautery and bipolar energy. The lymph node packet is mobilized laterally from the skeletonized common iliac artery to expose the underlying psoas muscle fascia. The para-aortic and right common iliac lymph node packets are then grasped and brought out through the right iliac assistant port and sent for permanent pathological examination. The fascia overlying the psoas muscle is incised medial to the genital femoral nerve to commence the external iliac vessel dissection. The proximal external iliac artery and vein have now been skeletonized circumferentially to the origin of the hypogastric artery. The obturator nerve is identified inferiorly as the external iliac vein is retracted medially. The nerve is also identified proximally and carefully dissected free of all lymphatics. The obturator lymph node packet is retracted medially and all small tributary vessels and lymphatics are controlled with bipolar cautery. The lateral vascular pedicle to the bladder has been isolated and divided. The left endopelvic fascia is incised adjacent to the prostate and the levator muscles are carefully swept off the lateral and apical portion of the prostate. In appropriately selected individuals, a nerve-sparing technique is employed for both continence and potency factors. We now turn our attention to the level of the aortic bifurcation. The peritoneum is incised to expose the underlying vessels and associated lymphatics. The aortic bifurcation lymph node packet is then sent off and blocked for permanent fixation. The right ureter has been dissected into the deep pelvis well beyond its crossing over the iliac vessels. Undyed vicryl ties have been used to ligate the ureter. A section of the proximal cut ureter is also sent off for frozen section analysis. The paracaval and right common iliac lymphadenectomy is completed, and the packet is sent off separately. The presacral lymph node packet is dissected off the sacral promontory, and careful attention is paid to control any small arterial and venous branches coursing along the anterior surface of the sacrum. At this point, the external iliac and obturator lymphadenectomy has been completed. The right lateral vascular pedicle to the bladder is isolated and divided with another application of the 45 millimeter endo-GIA stapler using a vascular cartridge. More than one application may be required to control the pedicle distally. The posterior pedicle is divided high and just outside the tissue surrounding the seminal vesicles using harmonic scalpel energy. The plane between the rectum and posterior sheath of Denon Villiers is developed in combination of sharp and blunt dissection. The bladder is dropped from the overlying abdominal wall by dividing the uracus and the fibroareolar connection between the anterior bladder wall, prostate, and undersurface of the pubic symphysis. The dorsal venous complex is controlled and ligated with an application of the EndoGIA 45mm stapler utilizing a green load cartridge. The apex of the prostate and membranous urethra is now exposed. The urethra is incised anteriorly just beyond the apex of the prostate. A 2-0 suture is placed in the posterior urethra at the 6 o'clock position to facilitate the neobladder urethral anastomosis. The posterior urethra is then incised and the specimen mobilized cephalad. A frozen section is sent from the distal cut urethra to ensure the absence of carcinoma in situ or tumor, which would exclude the option for orthotopic urinary diversion. A 2-0 figure of 8 suture is used to close the prostatic urethra to prevent potential tumor spill before the specimen is entrapped. The limits of our meticulously performed lymph node dissection are demonstrated. Proximally, the dissection extends from just above the aortic bifurcation and extends laterally over the inferior vena cava to the genital femoral nerve, representing the lateral limit of dissection. Distally, the lymph node dissection extends to the lymph node of cloacae medially on Cooper's ligament and the circumflex iliac vein laterally. The spermatic vessels are spared laterally. All fibroareolar and lymphatic tissue has been dissected off the aorta, the common iliac vessels over the sacral promontory, into the deep pelvis. A 10-centimeter incision is made to extract the specimen and provide exposure for the extracorporeal neobladder creation. Once the ileal neobladder has been formed and the ureteral ileal anastomoses have been completed, the neobladder is then placed back into the abdominal cavity. The robot is redocked and the neobladder urethra anastomosis is performed intracorporeally. A series of interrupted 2-0 sutures are used to ensure a watertight anastomosis.